Welcome to River Valley for the 2020 River Valley Commencement Ceremony. I am Barry Dutt, the high school principal, and I want to thank the graduates, parents, family members, staff, and the River Valley community for tuning in and taking part. Graduates, it has been my pleasure to have been your principal, assistant principal, and athletic director over the course of these past 4 years. I've had the opportunity to watch you grow and mature since the first day you entered the high school doors. I must say this class has done amazing things in the classroom, during performances, in academic and athletic competitions. Because of these experiences, I believe you all will go on to do many great things. My hope for you is that you follow your passions and interests, and continue to pursue your future goals. Class of 2020, as you move from students to alumni, I hope that you will stay in touch, stay involved, and communicate those many successes. I want to say a special thank you to our graduates that have chosen to enter the armed services. Thank you for choosing to protect our rights and freedoms. I wish you all safety as you pursue this path. I want to take this time to thank our veterans that have served, as well as those individuals that are currently serving. Your service and selflessness are to be commended. Class of 2020, congratulations.
Good evening. I want to welcome our Board of Education, our families, and our graduates here to the commencement ceremony for the River Valley High School class of 2020. This is a special day, and as many of you know, this is my first River Valley High School commencement ceremony, and I'm honored to be speaking here. This has been an unusual year for all of us. With the school closure and pandemic, it has not been a typical year, class of 2020. But I will say that what has stuck out to me is how the River Valley community has come together during this time. And that includes this senior class. Although this hasn't been an ideal time, these last 2.5 months are really a microcosm for what life is like. How will you respond when you are faced with something that you have never dealt with before? I encourage you to always try to push through any difficult times. That is what will define you and will really define a great deal of your success in life. As graduates, or soon to be graduates, of River Valley High School, you have developed close bonds with your classmates, some for 12 to 13 years. These memories will bind you together even as you go your separate ways. Remember, you will always be part of the River Valley family. Yesterday you were students, today you are graduates, tomorrow you will be alumni. I want to congratulate you, class of 2020, on your accomplishment, and God bless you.
Good evening, everyone. I am Kajal Desai, the class president of the class of 2020, and I am honored to have the pleasure of welcoming our students, staff, and family members to the 2020 graduation ceremony. Thank you to the River Valley staff members for being so supportive to our graduating class. We very much appreciate the immense effort that has gone into planning a memorable graduation ceremony this year. Thank you to our families as well for taking care of us through this unexpected time and for making our class feel loved and appreciated. I know that we are all ecstatic to be receiving our diplomas and to be graduating from high school. We have been looking forward to this day since the day we began our schooling. Today's ceremony will be especially thought-provoking given the fact that it is not a traditional graduation ceremony. Ironically, despite this year's graduating class being the class of 2020, no one could have seen our graduation ceremony happening this way. Our class will forever be bound by the fact that we graduated in the middle of a pandemic, which just goes to show how resilient we all are. We are all strong human beings that will go on to do amazing things in this world. Our graduating class has become a family during our time at River Valley. Over the past 13 years, we have all seen each other grow into wonderful human beings. I, for one, cannot wait to see the big things that each and every one of my peers will accomplish in the future. Today is our last day as high school students, and today is also the first day of the rest of our lives. Once again, it is my great honor to present to you the remarkable class of 2020. Congratulations.
I was so excited when I got the list of this year's valedictorians. I was so excited because I realized I grew up with these ladies. I've seen all the hard work they've put into school and their whole lives to just make it to this point. And most amazingly, I've seen them develop their individual passions that I believe they're going to take out into the world and just do great things with and truly make a difference. So I'm so excited and honored to announce this year's valedictorians: Allie Dutt, Melanie Amy, Olivia Kirk, and Morgan Stith.
Good evening, everyone. I would like to start off with a quote by Christina Dawson. Entitlement and gratitude cannot occupy the same space. Not one of us here were entitled to the education we have received for the past 13 years. Not one of us were entitled to the family, friends, and nurturing relationships that got us here today. Today should be a reflection of gratitude for the many events that shaped our lives so far, our education, and the blessings that we truly have around us. If you do not have gratitude, you will always see entitlement and never experience true joy. You see, I was not entitled to a life of being healthy. I was born 3 months early and given a 20% chance of survival. I spent 6 months in an intensive care unit before I got to come home for the first time. All of the factors that were needed to ensure my health were out of my control. But because of these things, the nurses, the doctors, the people that had never met me that were praying for me, and my family who never gave up their faith in God no matter what my outcome was to be, is why I'm so grateful for the ability to study, learn, and love others. I was not entitled to this life or education, but I will be a great steward of the gifts that I have been given. Many of you know me, but do you really? Each of you, along with me, have our own unique story. Be a light has truly been a saying that I have come to love and learn from. This saying reminds me to set a great example for others, encouraging others in all that they do, regardless of their story. I am on this earth to be a witness for the kingdom of God, and that is what I've held close to my heart. Are you brave enough to know your neighbor's story? Are you brave enough to become invested in someone other than yourself? Are you brave enough to not go along with the crowd and judge upon appearance? Are you brave enough to love unconditionally? My fellow graduates, I challenge you this evening to become someone from this day forward that you have always wanted to be, not just in career path, but in integrity and character. Be someone from today forward that others can trust and admire. Be someone from today forward that you will be glad to tell your children about. Do kind deeds without a reward, but anything other than the joy that it will bring to your heart. Although this is not the ideal graduation, in a couple of years, we will realize that it isn't the most important thing in the world. Kindness, respect, human lives, and family are. Please try to find the blessings that we have been given, that have been given to us during this time, such as extra time with our families before we go off to be adults. I leave you with one final thought. One of the verses that I have come to know and love is Jeremiah 29:11, which states, "For I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to give you hope and a future." I know that God will never forsake me during this transition to college, and that is such a blessing. Congratulations, class of 2020. We did it. Throughout this next chapter of life, I encourage you all to be a light.
Good evening, and congratulations, class of 2020. We did it. We survived high school and have earned our diplomas. As this chapter of our life ends, it's time for us to turn the page and start a new one. People have always asked us questions about our future and what we want out of it. Now it's time for us to make those decisions and learn from the mistakes we make. The world is going to throw us curveballs, and there will be unexpected outcomes and challenges. My advice is to rise to those challenges. Approach every obstacle with a positive attitude and believe in yourselves. To quote a man named Kevin Michael, small shifts in your thinking and small changes in your energy can lead to massive alteration of your end result. With his wise words in mind, I advise you to keep kindness and hope in your hearts and work to make your dreams become reality. We have seen firsthand just how fast things can change, and we have learned that the best way to handle change is to adapt and keep going. During our time at River Valley, we have learned so much beyond our teachers' lesson plans. We have learned valuable life lessons and things about ourselves that has helped shape us into the people here today. I would like to take a moment to thank some people that have helped me through this journey. My mom and dad for always being honest with me and being my biggest fans. My friends and family for their support and love and for believing in me even when I didn't. The teachers and faculty, without you, there would be no graduation. You've taught and helped us so much over the years. And thank you to everyone who has made it possible for this class to be here today. Fellow graduates, I encourage you to always surround yourself with people who make your life better, like those that have helped you make it this far. We often forget to thank the people close to us and those that help us most often. So I'd like to encourage you to always remind those people just how much you appreciate them. The future is now ours to make the present, so let's make it one that will inspire future generations. Thank you.
12 years is a long time. It's the amount of time we've spent as students, taking quizzes that seemed impossible, and memorizing things that we've entirely forgotten by now. Yet, when you look back at it, the time you spent here doesn't seem that long. There are moments when you didn't think you could do it. Moments when you just wanted to skip ahead to the part where you were done. This is the part where you are done. Once you leave today, you don't ever have to come back. 12 years was long enough, and a lot has happened in that time. When we were just starting elementary school, the first iPhone was released. We were barely old enough to understand what the Olympics were when Usain Bolt became the fastest man alive. We were in third grade when Instagram debuted, and we witnessed the rise and fall of Vine, which was so traumatic that some of us still quote Vines today. We got to grow up watching miracles happen every day. We saw Michael Phelps through 17 of his Olympic gold medals, and we cheered when the Cavs came back after trailing 3-1 in the NBA Finals. Elon Musk sent a Tesla into space while we were making fun of kids for their Fortnite dances. No matter what anyone says, we are the lucky ones. We've looked to each other when everything seemed like it was falling apart, and we made it to the end. We've had 12 years to watch the world change, and now we have the rest of our lives to be the ones changing it. There will be a new Michael Phelps, a new iPhone, and new miracles. Our 12 years are coming to an end, but any ending is just the next beginning. Thank you to everyone in the class of 2020. We've earned this.
A few weeks ago, shortly after we started taking classes online, my ag teacher, Ms. Seckel, sent us a message. A message that you might have seen on social media or might have seen through a parent, and it reads as follows. Dear high school seniors of 2020, you were born when the world was grieving 9/11, and you graduate as the world grieves a pandemic. Although your two biggest launches into freedom, birth and graduation, have taken place in the midst of tragedies, just know that the world is an amazing, loving, and beautiful place, and it is waiting for you with open arms. We grieve with you that your senior year is ending this way, but we can't wait to see how you overcome and soar. Now, I don't know about you, but when I first read this message, I was filled with hope. Previous to receiving this message from Ms. Seckel, all I could focus on was how horrible and unfair the situation that we as seniors are forced into. Our entire education careers, we were told that these last few months would be some of the best months of our lives, and in an instant, it was taken from us. We lost our senior prom, our senior breakfast, and even a normal graduation. But over these last few weeks, I have seen and I've come to believe that the world is still truly an amazing, loving, and beautiful place, even in the midst of a pandemic. And even though we've had to miss out on a lot of experiences that lead to this momentous occasion, we are graduating, and the world is now at our fingertips. We have a freedom like never before to take what we have learned over these past 13 years and use it to make a difference in this world. Since freshman year, our class slogan has always been the class with a vision. And even though 2020 has not turned out to be this momentous and amazing year like we hoped and thought it would be at the end of 2019, I still believe that we are a class with a vision. I believe we will be able to see clearly as we find our way through this pandemic and as we go wherever our futures may take us. So congratulations, class of 2020. Despite everything that the world has thrown at us to try to stop and slow us down, we've did it.
Riley Marie Alcorn.
Allie Kirsten Armstrong. Megan Faith Bash.
Congratulations.
Jacob Allen Bateman. Mackenzie Joanne Bates. Madison Leanne Bales. Jackson Asher Bayless. Michaela Kelly Bell. Jillian Victoria Belton. Ethan Connor Bennett. Gabriel Blankenship. Christina Roseanne Bowling. Aaron Peyton Briggs. Mary Grace Bright.
Jenna Lee Burris. Caleb Scott Cameron. Zachary Kalen Campbell. Ethan Lane Castle. Justine Kaylee Chevalier. George Michael Clausing the Third.
George, congratulations.
Sabrina Ann Clayton. Cameron Cordell Cockrell. Jacob Lee Conley. Carson Bradley Craig. Jackson Thomas Crawford. Camry Rain Anna Lee Dean. Kajal Sanjay Desai. Xavier Haman Dingwa. Christian Michael Dobbins. Tyler Austin Dunlap.
Dalton Gunner Dutcher. Allie Esther Dutt.
Congratulations.
Emily Elizabeth Eichmeyer. Madison Elizabeth Elkert. Melanie Nicole Amy.
Congratulations.
Mason Daniel Flack. Christopher Hunter Gandert. Arshdeep Gill. Caitlin Elizabeth Grant. Megan Renee Gray. Jacob Douglas Green. Dolan Scott Greer. Anderson Jacob Grooms. Emily Marie Harrison.
Emily, congratulations. You're right here.
Madison Danielle Hawes. Taylor Addison Hecker. Amelia Violet Heinlein. Lauren Marie Herdman. Easton Richard Hoback. Sarah Adriana Hoffman.
Randall Allen Holmes. Jennifer Jane Hopton. Savannah Lynn Howard. Harley Ariana Howlett. Alex Michael Jankowski. Allison Mackenzie Johnson. Kyle Edward Kaiser. Stephanie Renee Carrick. Sydney Elizabeth Kohler. Olivia Carissa Kirk. Kylie Rochelle Lawson. Rachel Renee Lehner. Ashton Suzanne Livengood. Dustin Gage Lemaster.
Brandon Adam Levering. Madison Taylor Lingo. Roland Benjamin Linville. Maddie Marie Lott. Alyssa Rose Lyle. Christopher Marshall Mahoney. Justin Ora Main.
Mason Philip Thomas Markle. Camden Warren Marsh. Connor McAllister Martin. Alexander Jacob Matthews. Logan James McDowell. Timothy Michael McGuire. Jacob Robert Allen McInnes. Tyler Scott McMahon. Colin Michael Meadows.
Cy Preston Meddings.
David George Miller. Devin Elizabeth Miller. Jonathan Douglas Miller. Gabriella Lynn Neal. Logan David Neal. Aaron Anthony Nicolosi. Damian Mark Phelan. Ethan Eugene Pickens. Adeline Lee Rollins. Lexa Nicole Ray. Isabel Lynn Rice. Melanie Jade Robbins.
Austin Joseph Rollison. Daniel James Rollison. Maxwell Edward Russell. Tyra Nicole Russell. Bailey Elizabeth Ruth. Dante Michael Salyers. Matthew Dallas Sayers. Logan Schneider. Bailey Francis Schuff. Justin Ray Sloan. Aiden Paul Smith. Michaela Autumn Marie Spaulding. Cassidy Nicole Speakman. Gemma Therese Stars. Alexis Lynn Stevens. Morgan Renee Stith. Timothy Michael Stock. Elena Jean Stone. Gavin Lee Summers. Devin Chandler Schwartz.
Congratulations.
Angela Marie Temple.
Congratulations.
Braxton Blade Terrazas.
Andrew Tyrese Lee Thompson. Antonio Pierre Thompson.
Emma Grace Ann Teal. Hallie Elaine Troutman. Brittany Ann Vanover. James Michael Verrocchio.
Kevin Jeffrey Wade.
Kyle David Wade. Benjamin Thomas Wagner. Gabriel Brian Walker. Cameron Jeffrey Ward. Veronica Marie Watson. Mackenzie K. Wallet. Connor Andrew Ritmore. Edwin Anthony Zias.
In memory of Logan Richard Stevens, his mother, Lori Stevens, will be accepting his diploma.